today we are starting the new lesson, that is composition of a matter. Okay, so as you know that every substance is there, it is made up of some matter. Okay, so first of all we will see the can you recall question. From that you will revise the things you know about it. So first question is the what are the various states of matter. Yes, you knows that what are the states of matter. Yes, correct. It is solid, liquid and gaseous. These are the three states of matter. Okay, so and that was over for you in the previous classes. Next it is the what is the difference in ice, water and the what, steam. As you know that ice also made up of from the water. Water is also water only and steam is also a water. And in this the main thing is there, this ice is there, water is there, steam is there. It is nothing but it is a chemical combination of hydrogen and the oxygen H2O, that is the water molecule is present inside it. But what is the difference between ice, water and the steam? So ice is in the which state? As you know that ice is solid, water is liquid. Ice is solid, water is liquid and steam is there, it is in gaseous state. Next question is what are the smallest particle of matter is called. Okay, what are the smallest particle of a matter is called. The smallest particle of matter is called as a molecule. What is called a, it is called as a molecule. And what are the types of the molecules? So types of molecules are the, okay, if suppose it is a molecule of water, so H2O, here different hydrogen and oxygen combines together and it forms a water molecule. And if we take the example of H2 is also molecule, but here it is same, H combines with H and hydrogen molecule it forms. So here heterogeneous and the homogeneous is the type of matters. So we saw in previous standard that all the objects that we see in our surrounding or around us and also those which cannot be seen are made up of what happens, same and other matters. That is the question, means what they told you, all the objects whatever is there in front of you, it may be book, it may be what, anything is there, water may be, it may be food particles, it may be anything, that all are there. Okay, where we can see, you just move around you and see so many things are there that is around you, these things and also those you cannot see. For example, which thing we cannot see, that is the air is there that we can't see. Okay, so air is also inside it there that we can't see. It is also made up of same or the other matter. Okay, it made up of same or the other matter. Now can you take, classify the following matter into three groups. So which are those groups? Suppose it may be, first we will read the things name, then we will understand. Cold drink, air, sherbet, soil, water, wood and cement. If you read this thing, you will notice that cold drink is a liquid, air is a gas, air is a gaseous, sherbet is liquid, soil is solid, water is liquid, wood is solid, cement is solid. So we can classify these things into which groups, that is the solid, liquid and gaseous. And from this, soil, wood and cement, these are the solid things. Then cold drink, sherbet, these are, and water, these are the liquid things, and the air is in the gaseous, air is gaseous. What are the states of matter that you used as a criteria for above classification? So which we use here, that is solid, next it is the liquid and lastly gaseous. Okay, so these criteria we use for the classification of these things into the different groups. Okay, now the next thing, Try this. Take a small mustard seed in a transparent plastic jar. What we have to take? We have to take those small mustard seeds we have to take in a transparent plastic jar. Take a long stretch in this rubber diaphragm and fix it, and what happens on the mouth of the jar. So suppose this is the mouth of the jar, and on this is the balloon is there, we have to stretch and fix on it, okay? And so it will look like that, and we have to tie one thread here to this what rubber diaphragm, okay? Next, what will happen, what we have to do, just see here. Means of needle, thread a long thread at the center of the big balloon and by means of the needle and tie it tightly, okay? We have to tie it tightly with this bottle. Now what we have to do? Stretch the rubber diaphragm and fix it to the mouth of the jar by means of a rubber band. Now pull the diaphragm up and down with the help of thread, first slowly and then moderately force and vigorously. Record your observation what by the table. Okay, so first of all, here if we slowly we will push this diaphragm, rubber diaphragm, then what happens? Vibrations in the same place, then that rubber is there, it vibrates and it's a place only. When we moderately pull the diaphragm up and down, then what happens? Moderately the vibrations, what happens, it is increases than that of this, so vibration will takes place more, okay? And the vigorously, then it vibrates very much, and what happens then, it vibrates very fastly in the, what happens, that diaphragm will vibrate very fastly. Now we will see the activity which is there in our textbook, and then we will continue the next part of our lesson. So it is the activity of the mustard seeds that we are taking now. See here.
See children, this is what I am going to show. It is a bottle in which mustard seeds are put, and it is here you can see a rubber balloon I have taken. Now I will see when I mode of pulling of the diaphragm. This is like it act as a diaphragm. Diaphragm is nothing but a plaf or a parda, you can say. Just if I pull it, just moderately if I pull it or slowly if I pull it.
Observe when she is pulling it moderately, how the seeds, what happen, jumping at that places only. When she is pulling the seeds, pulling the diaphragm little bit moderately, then what happens, seeds are jumping and they are, what happens, coming little bit height. And when she is pulling it vigorously, that seeds are there, they are jumping till the top of the or the upper end of the bottle. Okay, see here.
Or vigorously, you can see the different vibration of that seed. So let's see that if I'll just pull it slowly, just see? You see, only the seeds will move. But if I move little moderately with the force, they jump it. But if I pull it very slow, you can see that all the seeds have come up. Once again, I'll demonstrate and show you. See, just if I let, they vibrate it. But if I pull it moderately with the force, they move it. But if I use vigorous force, vigorously, you can see that all the seeds will be jumping. Here, these are the three states how the molecules will be moving. When it is slow, means it is in a solid state. Moderately is in liquid state. And vigorously, the molecules movement is in gaseous state. Thank you, children.
Now we saw the activity, and that activity, you seen that how these mustard seeds are there. Okay, in above experiment, this experiment that we had seen inside it only, we have to put what the experiment on the above experiment. We give energy less or more the mustard seeds pulling the diaphragm up and down. Okay, whenever we are pulling it, you seen that when we pull it slowly, that mustard seeds, what happens, they are moving here only. But when we pull it moderate forcefully, they, what happens, jumps and till they acquire, they get till some height. and when you are vigorously they are pulling, that mustard seeds are there, they are moving. So from this what they told you, when they are moving on their place only, the slow force when we are applying to it, then that is how the particles are moving in the solid state. When moderately you are pulling, then what happens, how the particles of the mustard seeds are moving inside it, that is the liquid state inside that condition we can see. And when you pull it vigorously, at that time this shows the mustard seed how they are jumping, that is the state at the gaseous state. Okay, so we will see here what is the explanation given here. See here, in the above experiment we give energy less or more by pulling the diaphragm, rubber band diaphragm, to the mustard seeds by pulling the diaphragm up and down, making them above move differently. The particles in solid, liquid and gaseous state of matter have movement some or similar to that. The intermolecular force of attraction acts between the particles. As you know that there is an intermolecular force of attraction in between the particles. And in solid state it is, if you see here, they are very close to each other. And what happens due to this, what happens, this is the movement in mustard seed also we seen that. So they are very, there is a high intermolecular force is there in between, in the molecules of the solid. In liquid, as compared to the solid, if you see the picture here, the particles are little bit away from it, so the intermolecular force is less than that of the solids. And at last, in gaseous inside, the intermolecular force, if you see here, the particles are very far away from each other, so the intermolecular force is very less in that. So here, the extent of particle movement is determined the strength of the particle movement, determined by the strength of this force. The particle of solid are very close to each other and vibrate their fixed position. Okay, this, they are also vibrating, but it has a fixed position. In that position only what happens, they are vibrating. Next, due to the solid get the property like definite shape, and due to this close packed structure of the molecules, the solids have definite shape, definite volume. Okay, it is there, and we can make the hip from this. Okay, hips means we can make a, as you know that it is a collective noun for the collection of the things, a volume and also high density and non-compressibility. Okay, if you try to press the any wooden plank, otherwise what happens, any iron rod, it is not what happened, changing its shape. So why it is, because it is because of this close packed structure of the molecules, the volume and also high density and non-compressibility. Okay, its density is more and compressibility is also what happens, non-compressibility. These are the qualities of the solid substance, and this is because of this internal structure of the molecule. Now we will move towards the next. The strength of the intermolecular force is moderate in liquid state. Okay, in liquid state this intermolecular force is less, though it is not strong enough to fix the particles in the definite position. If you see, if you try to put the milk at one place, what happens, it is impossible. Okay, if it falls on the surface of the surface, if we put some pencils on the surface, what happens, it can be as it is, but when you are throwing water, otherwise milk, on the surface of the floor, what happens, it flow away, there is a slope, and it is due to this, the structure of the intermolecular structure of this particles of the liquid things. Now next, it is the due to this solid get the strength of intermolecular force is moderate in the liquid state, though it is not strong enough to fix the particles in a definite position, and that's why the liquids get the shape of the shape of the pot where we are keeping. If it is take the shape of the pot which we are keeping inside it, it is strong enough to hold them together, and as a result liquid have definite volume, that it has definite volume. However, they have fluidity. Fluidity means they flow towards the what, slope, and change their shape, not definite, but change in the accordance with the container. In which container if we are keeping, it takes the shape of that container. Okay, and the intermolecular force is very weak in the gases. If you compare, it with the gases, the intermolecular force is very less, and therefore the constituent particles of gases are there, they move freely. How we are vigorously when we pull it, then what happens? You see that the particles are moving so fastly here and there, and it is the state shows the state of the liquid substances. So if you see here in the picture, you will notice that the particles very far away from it, so they don't have definite shape and they don't have the definite volume. Therefore, constituent particles of gases move freely and occupy all the available space. Consequently, gases have neither definite shape nor definite volume. So solids have definite volume and definite shape. Liquids have definite volume, but it doesn't have definite shape because it acquires the shape of the container. And gases, they doesn't neither definite shape and nor definite volume. So these are the schematic representation and submicroscopic picture of the physical states of matter, and the table 6.3 shows that the characteristics of the states of the matter. Okay, so here it is, the table. So physical states of the matter. So which are the physical state? As you know, that solid, liquid and the gases. Now we will see the fluidity. What is fluidity? Fluid means flow from here to there. Okay, rigidity means how strong it is. Plasticity means it is plastic, how it is movable. Okay, or rubber, how it is there, its structure. The structure is called as the plasticity or the elasticity. So first of all, we will see the solid. From these above characters, which is fluidity, rigidity, plasticity and the elasticity, solid shows the rigid. Okay, iron rod is there, it is strong, it is rigid. Plasticity, plastic is there, how it is there, and elasticity, rubber. These are the solids thing, and they show this character. And liquids, they show the only character, that is the fluid. And gases also fluid, they move from one place to another. How is the volume? Volume, these all have, means solid have the definite volume. Liquids also have definite volume, means we 1 kg jawar, bajra we can buy, 1 liter milk we can buy. This height has a definite volume, but gaseous, it doesn't have definite what volume. Now concerned with the shape, the solids have the definite shape. Yes, as you know that solids have the definite shape. Liquids, they don't have the definite shape. They are taking the shape of the container. And gaseous, what happens? It moves from here to there. It doesn't have the definite shape. Next, it is the compressibility. You try to compress the iron and whatever it is there, but what happens? It is negligible. We cannot compress it. Liquids, we can compress it little bit, and gaseous, we can compress it very high. Next, it is the intermolecular force. As you seen the structure above, you notice that here in this structure, the particles are very close to each other. Here it is, very close to each other. They are away from each other, and they are very much away from each other. They are far away from each other, and that is only the means. It is because of the which thing in solids. They are very close to each other, therefore it has a strong intermolecular force in between the particles of a matter in the solid states. Then as you see in the picture above, the liquids are little bit away from each other, and that's why what happens, they have the what, the little bit moderate intermolecular force in between the particles of the liquid. And lastly, air are very weak or gaseous. As you know that one particle is here, one is here, one is here. So it is very less or very weak intermolecular force is present in between the particles of the gases. Next, it is the distance between the particles. As you seen above, here it is. As you seen above, the particles are very close to each other. They are little bit away from each other, and they are very far away from each other. That thing only we have to write here. The distance between the particle, very minimum. Liquid inside means solids are very minimum distance is there in between the particles. Liquid inside moderate distance is there, and at last gases inside very large distance is present in the particles of the gases. So these are the characteristics of the states of matter. Okay, so today you have to write these characteristics, read this part, okay, draw this figure, okay, and next part of the lesson we will see tomorrow. Okay, so today we will stop here only. Okay, and just read the lesson, underline the hard words and write it in your notebook. So today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.